In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to present your flyers and other graphic design works on Instagram like this. And this is coming up. Hello everybody and welcome to the channel once again. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So after you're done with your designs like this, that, and any other practical designs, especially in this video, I'll be focusing so much on flyers because that's what I do the most, and I believe most of you are here because of flyers, right? So after you're done with your design like this, and especially if you did it in A4, A3, how do you present it on Instagram? I get this message a lot that some of the parts of the flyers get cut off, and that is true because this size here won't fit straight into the Instagram algorithm. The Instagram size is such that it is either 4x4, 8x8, 16x16. That is a perfect square. So if you make your design something like this kind, it is okay and it can easily fit into the Instagram algorithm without cutting any part of it. But if you design your works in something like A3 like this one, or let's say A4, some of the part of the design is going to get cut off. And one of the simplest way that you can actually get this done is use mockups. But the problem with using a lot of mockups is that most of the times it looks cliche, and especially those ones that are free, a lot of people tend to use it, so it kind of looks overused. So the simplest way is you design or you come up with your own style, and in this video I'm going to share about three ways you can do that and you can present your works on Instagram. Let's jump right into it. So the first one is I'm going to make use of this particular flyer. Let me know in the comment section if you want a step-by-step tutorial on this flyer. And oh, I did this for a friend who is having his Night of Bliss this Saturday, 24th October. So make sure you head over to check it out. So the first thing that you need to do is you are either going to save this picture as a JPEG and bring it into Photoshop to follow the same procedure, or you're just going to use the shortcut Control Shift and then E. This is going to merge all the layers together and make it sort of a picture. So if I hold Alt and turn this one off, you see that all my layers are off, but I still have a complete picture here. We can use this particular picture to, or this merge image, to actually do what we are supposed to do. So what we do is, the first things first, create a new Instagram size. So we're going to use either 4x4, 8x8, or 16x16 inches. So file and then new, and we are going to change this one to inches here. So like I said, either 4x4 or 8x8. The only difference here is that the image size is going to increase. That means that there is going to be an increase in quality, but the size remains the same. For the sake of tutorial, whilst I'm using a lot of applications, let me just use 4x4. So this is going to create a perfect square for you, a perfect square that is going to fit on Instagram. Now let's go back to our flyer here, and we've already made a copy of the image. So with the help of the move tool, you can just drag this one onto the document that we created and we can place it over here. So you can see from here that this is a clear explanation that this size, the A3 or A4 size, is way bigger than the normal square size on Instagram. That is why it gets cut off. So over here, what we're going to do is we're going to right click on this one, turn it to smart object, and this is because we don't want it to lose a lot of quality. I've already explained that. So you press Ctrl T and then you're going to transform this one very nicely like that to make sure that it fits almost the document that you've created, so somewhere around here. And then you can press Ctrl A and make sure that it is centered in the middle. Now this is the first step to presenting or sending your works onto Instagram. With this, you can easily post your work on Instagram just like this one, because this, it is not going to cut off any of the parts that is, so you can see all your flyer details, and then you have a lot of space around it. Now, if you bear with me, you can see that this looks very plain, though it's good for presentation, but this looks way very, very plain because we have a lot of space here. So we can then go ahead to the next one to add a couple of things to it. So I'm going to use the most frequently asked question that I often get as well. How do you make copies of flyers and then you blur them? I use this a lot on my Instagram and a lot of people tend to ask me that question. So this is how we do it. With your main image selected or your main flyer selected like this, you go to view and then you're going to create a new guideline. This guideline is practically to help us keep the thing in balance. So you're going to create a 5% here, so the line is going to be here, so the image that we're going to duplicate, it will be around this area. Now we're going to subtract 5 from 100 and we do the same thing for the other side, and that is going to be 95% over here, so the interval at both ends are equal. Now we go ahead and then we're going to make a duplicate of this particular document, so Control J to duplicate this one, and then you can see that we have two documents or two layers over here. We will pick the one underneath and then we're going to press Control J to transform it, so we make that a little bit smaller. You hold shift and then you can drag it to this side, so you see that it just fits right to where you have your guideline. Now you're going to make a duplicate of that same layer and then you can drag it to this very side, so we have it at the both ends to be equal. And with this done, you can clearly see that this looks quite different. So if I turn these ones off, you see that this looks quite better than making it just plain and very simple. Now we go ahead and then we're going to add the blurness to it, so you can see from here that this looks the same as the one we have in front. So we're going to add a bit of blur to the background. So what we do is we're going to hold Control and select the two copies that we made. You're going to press Control E and then you're going to merge them, so this time around it becomes one layer instead of two separate layers. From there you can go to filter over here, go to blur and then Gaussian blur over here, and then you can add a bit of blur to it. At this point the radius determines how blurry it becomes, so you don't need to make it all that very blurry like this. Like you open it up like this, this doesn't really look nice, so you can go anywhere from this side, 4.5, it depends on your work, so you can add a bit of blur to it like this. And at this point you can see that the main flyer over here stands out, which makes it very, very interesting. Now you can go ahead and add a bit of shadows to it so that it doesn't really look like it is just standing, so drop shadow onto the main layer and then you can increase the size a little bit more like that. Now if you don't want this to look like it is hanging in thin air, you can create a couple of shadows underneath of it, and the first one is you can make a reflection. So to do the reflection, you just go ahead and make a duplicate of this by pressing Control J, press Control T to activate the transformation controls, right click and then flip it vertically. Now you can hold shift and drag this to the very bottom of the main image, so around here, and then you can use your opacity to create the shadow. Very simple, or let's say the reflection. So it looks like this one has casted a reflection at the bottom. Another way is you can create a shadow, and I see a lot of people use it, I also use it personally. And to do that, you're just going underneath of this layer, so you pick this layer, underneath of it you're going to create a new layer, or better still you can go for your rectangle to create a rectangle here like that, and you can press Control T to make sure that it fits to the very end of the flyer like this one. So let me just open this one up. Okay, so the next thing you do is you double click on it and then you're going to give it a color black and you click OK. Then you're going to right click on the layer and you're going to convert it to a smart object, right click and rasterize. This is because filters doesn't work on shapes, so you're going to filter, blur and then Gaussian blur, and then you can actually blur this one pretty much like this. You don't have to make it very much, and it doesn't have to be very small also. So something like this, and it looks like it stands on something. You can, if this feels like it is too much, you can actually reduce the opacity like this, and then it looks like it has created or casted a shadow underneath of. So this doesn't really look like it is standing in thin air anymore. And that is the first process. The second process is also quite similar to this one, so let me group all of this one and hide it. Now with my second process, I'm going to use this particular flyer. A link to how to do this is in the description. So I'm going to merge this one by pressing Ctrl Shift and then Alt and E, and then it is going to merge all of this one for me. From there, I'll choose my move tool and I'll drag it to our document, that is the 4x4. I'll press Ctrl T to transform this one out like this, and I'm going to press Ctrl A, position it in the very middle like that. Now let me zoom in so that you can actually see what we're doing. Let me close it up a little bit also like this. The idea of this second method is actually to use a very simple solid background that complements this design. So let me press Ctrl T to transform this some more like this one. And what I'm going to do is, underneath of this layer, I'm going to create a new solid color. So I'm going to pick a color within this one, something that complements it. So a color, something around here. You can actually take your time to pick any color, of course, but something that brings out this image at the same time, it complements it. So you don't pick a color that is going to make the design and the background merge together. You're going to just pick something quite lighter or brighter like this one. So let me use this, and I'll go ahead and I'll click OK. So what I do next is I'll make a duplicate. So let me transform this one some more like that. I'll bring it over here and I'll make a duplicate by pressing Ctrl J. Then I'll drag that over here and I'll push it down or bring it down like this one. So something like that. I'll then group these two, press Ctrl G to group it, and I'll press Ctrl A to make sure that it is centered. As you do this, you make sure that your centering and then your balance, everything is on point. So what I do next is I'll go to my first layer here or my first flyer, and then I'll right click on it, go to the blending options, and I'm going to add a drop shadow to it. So I'll drop the shadow something like this, and I'll reduce the opacity like that, and I'll click OK. You can even take your time at the drop shadow here to direct the angle of the shadow. So we want it at the left side, so you can direct it over here so that it comes to the left side. Perfect. And then what we're going to do is, since this is already grouped, we're going to make a duplicate and right click and convert it to a smart object. Press Ctrl T, right click on it, and then flip it vertically, and then we can drag this at the bottom, at the very bottom over here. And then what we can do is we can create a shadow. So you set it to 20%, 30%, or 40%, something like this. And when I turn off my guidelines, you can see some beautiful thing. You can take your time to adjust the background color to make this look nice. You see, this isn't really a mock-up, you just did it your own. And that is the second concept. Now let me group all of these ones and let's jump into the third and then the last concept. So with the third concept, I'm going to use this particular flyer. Link to how to design it will be in the description. So what I do is I merge it up and then I'm going to send it to the design or the documents. So I'll press Ctrl T just like we do for the rest, and we're going to position it in the middle. So you press Ctrl A, position in the middle like this one. Now the third idea, the third concept, is to use complementing colors from the design. So a maximum of two complementary colors from this design to create something simple, pretty much like a shape. So let's go ahead and increase this one. The idea here is you try to make this fill the entire document like this one, and with the help of your shape, preferably the rectangle tool, you can create some awesome shapes. So I'll go for my rectangle tool here, and I'm going to create a nice one like this one, and I'm going to change the color to something dark blue. So over here you can see that this simply complements the total design. We picked a complementary color from the design, and then we just used it. You can press Ctrl T, bring your cursor out of the transformation point, and then you can rotate it something like this one, and it looks very nice as well. You can either go this way, make it vertical, and then you can even make a duplicate of the same rectangle, try to transform it to the other side, something like this one, and then you're going to double click on the layer thumbnail here, change the color. So you see that you pick the first color from here, you are picking the second color from here, and then it complements it very beautifully. All the tips and tricks that I've shown you, I've used them on my Instagram. I use it to present my works on Instagram, and you can find them at @sir_innocent, and you can see all of these and many others over there. So yeah, those are the three ways that you can use to present your works beautifully on Instagram, and then any of these is going to, provided you use the size 4x4, any of these should work out perfectly fine for your design. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch this video. Please don't forget to check out my friend. The date is this Saturday, 24th October, and then the time is 6:30 p.m. streaming across all social media platforms. If you have any questions or concerns, leave them in the comment section and I'm going to attend to you right away. I'll see you guys in the next one. It's Innocent here, and bye.